So in children and adults, one does see features of what we call long COVID. One is what we have acute COVID, which can last for 4 weeks. And from 4 to 12 weeks, we have what is known as ongoing symptomatic COVID. And after 12 weeks, we really say this is post-COVID or long COVID. Studies both done in countries in Europe, both from Switzerland and from the Netherlands, showed that almost 30 to 60 to 70% of patients continue to have symptoms or some degree of symptoms even up to 2 months. But there are a significant number of people who will continue to have some symptoms. It could be persisting cough, it could be feeling of breathlessness, it could be chronic fatigue syndrome with body aches, joint pains, headache, or it could be brain fog that you're not able to concentrate. Symptoms can last for almost 6 to 8 weeks and even up to 12 weeks. And that is something that was reported even in the last, the first wave. We are seeing it now in the second wave, and even after the first wave, many hospitals, including ours, had set up a post-COVID clinic to really manage these patients. Long COVID does not indicate that the virus continues to be there. This is what we call a post-viral phenomena. That is, the virus is gone, but it has now sort of caused dysregulation in your immune system. And that takes a long time for it to sort of get back to a normal state. And it varies from person to person. It's not a treatment for long COVID. Vaccines, of course, are a treatment to prevent COVID, and you are wanting that with vaccination, you may get the infection, but you don't get a serious disease in terms of hospitalization and ICU admission. But they are not a treatment for long COVID. And here I'd also like to mention that we are also seeing people who may develop features of long COVID, even if they have mild illness. So it should not be felt that you will get long COVID only if you have moderate to severe illness. If you have these symptoms, you must first pace yourself. Don't overexert yourself for the first 4 to 6 weeks. Prioritize your activities so that you do most of your activities in the morning when you are fresh. Take a lot of breaks and don't overexert yourself. Do some breathing exercise. Light yoga is something that we advocate. And some degree of good diet in fresh fruits, green leafy vegetables. Meditation also does help in those who have problems of concentration and insomnia. And with time, gradual recovery will occur. Sometimes symptomatic treatment needs to be taken for cough or for joint pains or body aches. But by and large, most people will recover by the 6 to 8 weeks.